Now this video is on the geometry, that is the calculation of area for standard figures. Let we have a square here of side A by A. The area of this figure is A square. In this case the diagonal will bisect. So each angle will be 45 here. This angle is 45 and all angles are 45. So the length of diagonal is D1 and this length is equals to D2. So if you apply Pythagoras, we can find out the length of diagonal D1 and D2 is equals to root 2 times A, and area of the square is A square. A square can be written as root 2 multiplied by A whole square divided by 2. So area can also be equals to 1 by 2 D1 into D2. So alternately, if the diagonal is given, we can find out the area directly. Suppose we have a rectangle here, and if we have the base equal to B and height is H, and we draw the diagonal here, the diagonal will not bisect, and we can calculate the length of diagonal as D1 is same as D2 is equals to, by Pythagoras we have under root of B square multiplied by H square. If we have a parallelogram whose two sides are parallel and other two sides are parallel, so whenever we have a parallelogram and if we draw the diagonal, then this diagonal and similarly they can bisect each other. That is, this length is same as this length and this length is same as this length. Suppose we are given any triangle whose sides are equals to A, B and C. Then we can calculate the area based on semi-perimeter. So semi-perimeter is defined as the sum of all sides divided by 2. That is A plus B plus C divided by 2. That is semi-perimeter. And in that case we can calculate area as S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. This is a famous Heron's formula. Based on this one, we'll find number of questions. That is on Heron's formula. The area of the triangle whose sides are given as 15, 16 and 17, you have to find out area of this triangle. So in this case, we can find out the semi-perimeter as 15 plus 16 plus 17 divided by 2. So semi-perimeter is 24. In that case, we have to use the formula S into S minus A. So we have A equals to 24 multiplied by S minus A. That is 24 minus 15 is 9, 24 minus 16 is 8, 24 minus 17 is 7. So this answer come out to be 24 root 21 meter square. In this case, we are given one triangular lawn of 1600 square meter. One side is 64 meter, so this side is 64 meter and other two sides are equal. So let's say equal side equal to X. So in this case we can calculate semi-perimeter as S equal to X plus X plus 64 divided by 2. So we have S equals to X plus 32. In that case, area will be equals to S into S minus 64, S minus X into S minus X. And we know the area. So area is 1600 equal to under root of S is X plus 32 into X plus 32 minus 64 is X minus 32 into S minus X. So X and X is cancelled, so we left with 32. Again X minus X is same as 32. So you can square it and you can solve it. So approximately we get an answer X equals to 59.36 meters. Choice B is correct. If all the sides of a triangle are increased by 200%, you have to find out the percentage increase in the triangle area. So each side is increased by 200%. So let's say we have three sides as A, B and C. So in that case, area will be equals to under root of S, S minus A, into S minus B into S minus C. It clearly indicates that the area is proportional to S square. S to the power 4 is proportional to under root of S to the power 4. So area is equal to S square. So all the sides are increased by 200%. It means that 200% increase by increase means it's a 3 times of A, 3 times of B and 3 times of C. So therefore area is proportional to 3S square. That equal to total rise is 900%. 3 square is 9. Remember here is by means you have to add the original value plus 200 times. Two adjacent sides of parallelogram are 60 and 40. One of the diagonal is 80. We have to find out area of parallelogram. So in this case we have parallelogram here. One side is 60, second side is 40, and we have one diagonal. So let's say the diagonal is like this and the length of diagonal is 80. Now this parallelogram is basically consists of two triangle, and we can calculate the area of this triangle. Other triangle has same area. So we are using the formula for semi perimeter here, that is S equals to 40 plus 60 plus 80 divided by 2. So semi perimeter is 90. Hence we have a standard formula for area is under root of S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So the area will come out to be after substitution. S equal to 90, A equal to 60, B is equal to 40 and C is equal to 80. You will get 300 root 15. So total area of parallelogram will be 2 times of area of triangle, will be 600 root of 15. We are given a quadrilateral ABCD. The sides AB, BC, CD, D are given to us. And one of the diagonal is given to us. So you have to find out area of the quadrilateral. Almost same problem, except the sides are different. So they are different. This is not a parallelogram. So let's say this side equal to 24. This one is 13, is 17 and 10. So this one is A, B, C and D. And we have given a diagonal here, AC diagonal. So AC diagonal is given as 21. So this time we'll calculate the area of the two triangles. This is triangle 1 and triangle 2. Independently calculate two areas and then add. So for triangle ABC, we have semi perimeter is 20 plus 13 plus 21 divided by 2 is 27. So area of the triangle will be ABC. Using the standard formula, we can calculate. That is same formula you have to apply. Sides are already known to us, 20, 39, 17, S equal to 27. So if you substitute, you will get this answer equals to 126. Repeat this procedure for other triangle, that is triangle ADC. First of all, find out semi-perimeter, which is 10 plus 17 plus 21 divided by 2 is equal to 24. Hence, we can calculate the triangle area of ADC using the same Heron's formula, which will be 84. So now, finally, add these two area and the total area come out to be 210. In a parallelogram, the length of adjacent sides are 12 and 14. If the length of one diagonal is 16, you have to find out the length of other diagonal. So this time we can apply Pythagoras. We have D1 square plus D2 square will be 2 times of A square plus B square. One of the diagonal is 16. So we have 16 square plus D2 square equal to 2 times 12 square plus 14 square. Solve this, you will get the length of other diagonal 20.6 cm.